हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी विल सी द इंटरपोलेशन पार्ट. इंटरपोलेशन इज रिकंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द ओरिजिनल इंफॉर्मेशन सिग्नल फ्रॉम द सैंपल्स. x of t इंटरपोलेशन, वी आर डिस्कसिंग इंटरपोलेशन. वी आर डिस्कसिंग इंटरपोलेशन. Interpolation is being discussed. Okay, so x of t forms Fourier transform pair with x of f. X of s is my sampled version, which is Fourier transform pair, which forms Fourier transform pair with x s of f. Now we have already derived that this Fourier transform of original information signal can be obtained. This is already derived in part 1 from the samples sigma x of n by 2b. This relation we have already derived, minus j 2 pi n f upon 2b, and here it will be 1 upon 2b. B is the highest frequency in information signal. That means the information signal spectrum is band limited to B hertz. Now we know that x of t is the inverse Fourier transform of x of f. See here, this forms Fourier transform pair with x of f. That means x of t is the inverse Fourier transform of x of f. X of t is inverse Fourier. So if I have this spectrum, I can retrieve the information in time domain by using inverse Fourier transform. So I will be having inverse Fourier transform x of t. This is inverse Fourier transform, definition of inverse Fourier transform. So it is integration. See, inverse Fourier transform is using, we can find inverse Fourier transform using integration, because our Fourier transform is continuous function of frequency. Don't forget, Fourier transform itself is a continuous function of frequency. So here integration x of f e raised to n plus j 2 pi f t df. Why df? Because x of f, this is function of frequency. So we will be integrating relative to frequency. So here it will be from minus b to b hertz, because this spectrum is band limited to b hertz. So it will be from minus b to plus b. So it will be like this, sigma n equals to minus infinite to infinite 1 upon 2b. We have already derived this, so I will be using just x of f. Ye humne already derived kar liya hai. So I am replacing that x of f. X of n upon 2b e raised to minus j 2 pi n f upon 2b into e raised to. So this part is we have already derived. वो मैंने सिर्फ रिप्लेस किया है. सो हियर इट विल बी ई रेस टू प्लस जे टू पाई एफ टी डी एफ. देयरफॉर आई कैन राइट सिग्मा एन इक्वल्स टू माइनस इनफाइनाइट टू इनफाइनाइट x of n upon 2b, 1 upon 2b integration minus infinite to infinite e raised to plus j 2 pi f, this I am integrating that part, f t, first I combine this to minus n upon 2b. So I have taken e raised to minus j 2 pi f as common, plus j 2 pi f as common, so I will be having t minus n by b, n by 2b. So now let us continue. So now if we apply the integration, if we apply integration over here, it will be sigma n equals to minus infinite to infinite x of n upon 2b. If I apply integration, it will be like this. 1 upon 2b. Then integration of e raised to ax is integration e raised to ax. See here, I am integrating this part. I am integrating this part. I am integrating the dashed part. I am integrating dashed part. So it will be the integration of e raised to ax. E raised to ax is e raised to ax upon a. So here it will be e raised to j 2 pi f t minus n y 2 b upon j 2 pi t minus n upon 2b, limits are minus b to plus b. Limit is minus b to plus b. If I apply the limits, what will be the result? If I apply the limits, what will be the result? So my x of t will be sigma n equals to minus infinite to infinite x of n upon 2b, 1 upon 2b. If I apply the limit, so I can cancel it now if I apply. So it will be 1 upon j 2 pi 1 upon 4 pi b t minus n upon 2b into e raised to j 2 pi b t minus n upon 2b minus e raised to minus j 2 pi b upon 2b. So I applied the limits. So this will be n equals to minus infinite to infinite x of n upon 2b sine of 2 pi b p minus n upon 2b upon 2 pi b. See, right now I applied the trigonometric relation, which is just, see, let me show you the reference. We know that e raised to j theta e raised to j theta minus e raised to minus j theta upon 2j is sine of theta. So I have used this e raised to j theta minus e raised to minus j theta upon 2j equals to sine theta. So the result will be sigma n equals to minus infinite to infinite x of n upon 2b sine of 2 pi b p minus n pi, I expanded this brackets, upon 2 pi v t minus n pi. This will be the result. So now if you remember sine theta by theta, when theta tends to 0 is sine theta by theta is sinc function. It is a sinc function. So instead of sine theta by theta over here, I'll be writing sinc theta, S-I-N-C. So my result will be, x of t equals to sigma n equals to minus infinite to infinite x of n upon 2b, these are the samples, sinc of 2 pi bt minus n, this is sinc. Sine theta pi theta upon theta is sinc theta. So this came because, sine of pi theta by pi theta is sinc theta, S-I-N-C, sinc theta. That is why I can write it like this. So this is interpolation formula. Interpolation means this is reconstruction formula. This is, this entire equation is called the reconstruction formula. So if I multiply the samples, if I multiply the samples by a sinc signal and sum all the values, then we can reconstruct the information signal. So this is interpolation formula for low pass signal. Interpolation formula for low pass signals. We can discuss this in graphical manner. Again, if the samples are multiplied by, see this is shifted sync, by sync which is shifted, and sum all the values, then we can reconstruct the original information signal. So this was the mathematical derivation. Now we'll discuss the graphical part. So graphically, if I discuss in time domain, this is my axis of t. The samples are at 0, at ts, then at 2 ts, then at 3 ts. You can assume any sample value, minus ts, at minus 2 ts, and so on. And here also, this is my index n. Now if I multiply it by sync sequence, sync signal, sync is like this. If I take the projections of the instances, then the amplitude is decreasing. See, this is sync. So if the sync is multiplied, this is one sync, this is single sync signal, single sync signal. So if I multiply this signal, which is concentrated at zero, so this is sync without shifting. This is sync without shifting. This is sync at 2BT only. This is without shifting. So if you refer the previous equation, this is when n is 0, without shifting. So this will be multiplied with this sample and the result will be over here. Similarly, if I multiply it at this instant TS with the sample, then sync signal itself is 0. So if 0 is multiplied by the sample value, that sample will not be there. Now, next shifted sync is where the shifted sync will be over here, concentrated at TS. Shifted version of the sync will be concentrated at TS. So now my sync will be like this. At TS it is there, then after the amplitude this decrease. So at TS the peak is there, then after the amplitude will decrease. So if I multiply this shifted, this is shifted when n equals to 1. Similarly, it can be shifted left side when n equals to 0. It can be shifted left side when n equals to 0. If I multiply this sync with my samples, if I multiply this 2. The procedure was interpolation formula includes multiplication of the samples with the shifted sync signal and then will sum up. So if I multiply, then what will happen at 0? Now the sync signal, shifted sync signal is 0. So at 0 we will not get any sample. At 0 we will not get any sample. See here. At TS will get a sample. So this will be considered. So now I have this and this. Again I can shift the sync signal left side and right side. The same manner we had done in sampling. So this is reconstruction. It includes the same procedure, but now the signal is sync signal instead of impulse train. So now I can shift again, and then I can take one more sample value, and then I can rejoin. I can rejoin all the picks here. Then I can rejoin all the picks. So if I combine in one graph by summing up, if I apply sum now, after shifting multiplication, if I apply sum now, then it will be like this. Now I am summing, so it will be like this. This sample will be over here, similarly 2S. So then I'll be able to connect and I can regenerate all entire information signal. So this was regarding the graphical analysis of graphical analysis of the interpolation formula.